topic of today's instruction course. Let me have an introduction of the topic and speakers. Refraction history dates back 2000 or more than that. The prehistoric man might have been perplexed by the while he is looking at fishing or something, the actual position of the fish might have been mistaken for the apparent position. That might have wanted him to look for the refraction. In historic time, Moti, the Chinese philosopher, proposed the camera obscura, that is pinhole camera. Al-Hazen, an Arabic scholar, wrote a book on optics. In recent times, Isaac Newton, in his book Optics, consolidated system of optics, reflection, refraction, formation of images, dioptric system of the eye, and theory of colors. Later, Alvar Gullstrand won the Nobel Prize in 1911 for his contributions in astigmatism, theory of monochromatic aberrations, dioptrics of crystalline lens, intracapsular mechanism of accommodation, and invention of slit lamp. Anomalies of optic system. Johannes Kepler discovered myopia in 1611. Isaac Newton demonstrated hypermetropia in 1704. Thomas Young proved astigmatism. This is Thomas Young. C.A. Baruch coined accommodation in 1841. Franz Cornelius Dondes did the classical work on the anomalies of accommodation and refraction of the eye. Dondes. Clinical methods of estimating refraction. Hermann Snellen, everybody knows, is invented test types for testing visual sharpness in 1854. Retinoscopy was discovered by Bowman in 1859. Luminous retinoscope by Wolf in 1893, streak retinoscope by Jackson, and the trial lenses and frames by efforts of George Tobias Christoph Fraunmüller. Conrad Burns added prism bars in 1899. Spectacles. Chinese used spectacles for the first time by the year 2283 before Christian era to observe stars. Egyptian in 1500 BC had its industry. India, Japan, Greece, etc. utilize the magnifying properties of rock crystal, quartz, and transparent minerals. Salvino di Armato of Florence is the inventor of spectacles according to his tombstone inscription. Spectacle with convex lenses by Benito Daza di Valdis. Spectacle with concave lenses by Nicolas Cusanus. These are the some of the eyeglasses in that time. Then first spectacles were called nail eyeglasses, two monocles with metal frame joined by nail. This is that thing. Earpieces were discovered in 1728 by Edward Scarlett. Foldable hinges by James Iasco in 1752. Material used in frames were leather, iron, silver, gold, horn, tortoise shell and plastic. Benjamin Franklin in 1775 designed bifocals. First spectacles were called, where is that, not moving. Astigmatic lenses by Sir George Beadle Airy. Trifocals were invented in 1826 by John Isaac Hawkins. Adding various oxides to improve the quality of glasses were done. Crown glasses were discovered by Zeiss in 1885. Aspheric lenses in 1911 by Alvar Gullstrand. Progressive lens patented in 1907. You can see the difference between trifocal and progressive lens. Aspheric lens, chromatic aberrations makes the point is not focused. This is the focus in aspheric lenses. Contact lenses. Without satisfying the cosmetic purpose, the idea conceived by Leonardo da Vinci in 1508. The term contact lens is coined by A.E. Fick in 1888. scleral blown contact lenses by A.C. Muller in 1887, molded and later ground contact lenses were discovered. Plastic material introduced by Feinblum in 1937. The materials used were polymethyl methacrylate, lathe cut methyl methacrylate, soft hydrophilic lenses, rigid gas permeable lenses, hydrogel, silicon hydrogel. Then, without satisfying with that cosmetic purpose, they invented surgical refraction. Keratomeliosis by 1949 by Jose Ignacio Barrecuer, keratophakia in 1961, radial keratotomy in 1970 by Fodorov, epikeratophakia, keratomeliosis in situ with manual keratome in 1987, then automated keratome was discovered, photorefractive keratectomy with eczema lasers in 1983, LASIK from University of Crete in 1988, then LASIK, EPI-LASIK, conductive keratoplasty, intra-LASIK and SMILE, the invention goes on and goes on. Then surgical methods were discovered on the surface of the cornea, onlays and inlays. Onlays were placed below the epithelium, inlays were placed on the stroma. Then intraocular, without satisfying with that, they went on to intraocular devices. Phakic IOL, three types are there, angle-supported phakic IOL, iris-supported phakic IOL, posterior chamber phakic IOL. So, refractive errors, present scenario. More and more people are getting their vision corrected. Out of 7.7 billion of world population, 4 billion wear glasses. 660 million still remain uncorrected. Majority over 40 years wear correction. The correction increases to 90% after 50 years of age. Nearly all people after 75 years use correction. This is a graph showing as the age increases, the number of people wearing glasses increases. This is the comparison of contact lens and eyeglasses. LASIK surgery falling out of favor with patients. The procedures heyday was 2000 to 2007. More than a million of the outpatient surgeries were performed each year. This has dropped more than 50% from about 1.5 million surgeries in 2007 to 6 lakh in 2015. So, the spectacle is making a comeback. It is pocket friendly, money-wise, and you can put it in your pocket. No need of hassles of surgery. So, the speakers are Dr. Sahasranam V, Director and Professor HOD of RIO Trivandrum, past President of KSOS, present Managing Committee Member of IOS. He is speaking on enriching refraction. Dr. Andrew C.V. Kakanad, Professor and Superintendent of Jubilee Mission Medical College, Trichur, past President of KSOS, Managing Committee Member of KSOS, will speak on selection of spectacles, frames and lenses. Next is Dr. Radharamanan B, Director of Vision Eye Hospital, Kerala, past President of KSOS, Managing Committee Member of AIOS. He will be speaking on spectacle intolerance. Next is Dr. Nirmal Frederick, MD, Nirmal Sai Hospital, Chennai, Principal Assessor, NABH QCI, Member Secretary, IOS, NABH Expert Group. He will be highlighting setting up an optical unit, its inventory, management, and ethical aspects. Thank you.